Hi everyone, in this video, I'm going to talk about the product survey, the product analysis, and the supplier survey. As you remember, we are still looking at the elements of the market where we started with the consumer survey. Went ahead and talked about the competitor survey, and here we're going to also talk about product survey and supplier survey. What is product analysis? It means studying how well a product performs its purpose. Analyzing a product means studying how well product performs its purpose. So let's remind ourselves, what do we mean by a product? A product is anything that is offered to the market for attention, acquisition, use, or consumption that satisfies a want or a need. Ask ourselves the benefits of product analysis. Why should we carry out product survey? Why should we analyze a given product? One, it helps the entrepreneur to determine the products that are worth producing. Hope that is there. Two, it helps to determine a relevant price for a specific product. And the last one, again, helps us the entrepreneur to improve on the existing products to meet the customer requirements, and many, many others. What do we market? There may be goods, there may be services, there may be events, experiences, personalities, a place, an organization, properties, information, ideas, and concepts. As you can see, there's images there for Facebook, Microsoft, Coca-Cola. You remember in 2010 when we had the World Cup, I don't remember, but then maybe a student timer. Peps, Amazon.com, Google, among others. Successful, let's look at the successful person when it comes to marketing. I think we all know that. This is Mr. Bill Gates to do marketing. He has a successful marketing career. Who else do you know? I think there are lots of people that you might know who are successful entrepreneurs. PLC, which is product life cycle. So the third product comes into place, what are you supposed to do? One, think about the product, that is product development. And here we're saying there are no sales, the sales are zero, and you're going to spend a lot of money in investing for that product. Then at the introduction part, you're saying profits do not exist because we are just introducing now, but still we're spending lots of money on that product, introducing the given product into the market. Then three, that's the growth. Here, as it's growing, you're getting many customers, you get a rapid market acceptance, and then your profits will increase. And then four, the maturity. Time reaches and looks like people are used to your product, so the sales will slow down the sales growth, then the profit level offers, so increase outlay to compete. So at that stage you need to be more innovative. If not, you end up failing the losses. And the last one, the decline. Sales fall off and profits drop completely. So that is our PLC. Sometimes you can be asked to explain it. Let's look at it here with the sales volume and the time. The government said we here, we're just cutting, we're spending a lot of money investing in a given product, and there is no, the sales are zero, you haven't started so anything. At the introduction part, slowly but no sales at the same time, no profits, but you're still spending money on that product. The growth stage, that's when the product comes into the market and people have started accepting your product, then you use lots and lots of profits. So come to the fourth, which is the maturity. People have got used to your product. Let's just say this is also a very tricky stage. You need to think, otherwise you need to be sharp and be innovative. If not, otherwise you fall into the trench that is at the decline, starting to lose the profits and then you have losses. That's our PLC. Suppose you are starting a carpentry workshop for selling tables in a trading center. Explain briefly what criteria you base on in analyzing the product for your business. So, what criteria are you going to base on when analyzing a given product for your business? That is to do with carpentry, the furniture, selling tables. So, what criteria? After having brainstormed some, so let's look at the one, ergonomics. This means improving the design of the products to optimize them for human use. That is, making the right size of tables, if it's for kids, if it's for the old, height, length, and widths. That is to do with ergonomics, should have it in mind. Two, the cost. How much will it cost to manufacture the given product? And how much shall we sell them? So you should also think about this. How much are we going to spend on these tables that we're going to produce? And at the same time, how much are we going to sell them? Three, aesthetics. And they're saying the outward appearance or the style of behavior. Does the product look good? Is it stylish? Is the style to the consumer attractive? So that is to do with aesthetics. The outward appearance of your tables also matters a lot. At the same time, look at the style. So think if you've ever bought some, seen Turkish furniture, or Chinese furniture, even the furniture that is homemade here. You can check the different styles that you or the client or the customers have made. The next, construction method. How has the product been made? You should also think about it. What joining methods, techniques have been used? Is the product well constructed? Will it fall apart when in use? Or will it easily scratch? That makes some furniture. But if you just scratch a little bit, it's spoiled, so you should also have that in mind. Others include client requirements. They're saying it's a product, what the customers want, what changes are required to make the product suited for the client, does the customer like the product, so you also need to know health and safety. Is it safe? Does it fulfill the health and safety laws? To do with RSD. Color and texture. Is the current texture of your product effective? Or is it what the customer wants? Materials. Are the materials suitable for this type of product? Are they of quality? Or do they make the product look cheap? And lastly, we should also think about the environment, the environmental impact assessment. So seeing what is the environmental impact assessment of your product. Is it manufactured from materials supplied by sustainable sources or otherwise? Can these materials be recycled or reused? So these are some of the factors you should put into consideration. I think that is that. Now let's come to the supplier survey. This is a process used by a company to collect information from the current or prospective suppliers to gauge whether or not the supplier's specific social environmental criteria that is meaningful to that company. Such, as we said, the survey, you're going to start study about your supplier. And you have your supply chain. They're saying this is a system of organizations, people, activities, information, and resources involved in moving a product or a service from a supplier up to the last person, who is the customer. Or refers to the sequence of processes involved in the production and distribution of the commodity. The typical supply chain involves a variety of stages which might include the following. We have some transporters, warehouse, manufacturers, wholesalers, retailers, customers, agents, to mention that a few. So how do you get the potential suppliers? What's their source? You can find potential suppliers through a variety of ways. Much better and safer to build a short list of possible suppliers through a combination of sources to give you a broader base to choose from. 1. Recommendations. Ask friends and businesses, acquaintances, somebody you used to do business with, to recommend suppliers they know, or who have supplied them before. Such recommendations are likely to give you a good quality supplier. 2. Directories. These are always many business directories that list suppliers of different products. Passing through such directories will give you a list of potential supplier to contact. Trade associations. Many traders belong to trade associations. Such associations keep a register of their members and their nature of businesses. By checking with them, you can get a list of potential suppliers. Business support organizations. Business support organizations such as chambers of commerce or enterprise development agencies can recommend potential suppliers. Lastly but not least, exhibitions and trade shows offer another great opportunity to talk with a number of potential suppliers in the same place at the same time. Here you can easily check whether the exhibitors are relevant and suitable for your business. And lastly, the press, trade magazines, futures, advertisements from potential suppliers. A selection of trade publications and trade press listings should be available at your local business library. So these are some of the sources of suppliers, how we can get these suppliers. Then the types of suppliers, as stated above, different enterprises have different suppliers. Generally, the following general categories of suppliers can be identified. 1. Agents. These talk and supply products on behalf for other business people. We all know your ideas. Then manufacturers, they produce goods and supply them to wholesalers. Some manufacturers may supply directly to large scale retailers and consumers. Wholesalers, these are suppliers who supply to retailers and at times consumers in large quantities. Then retailers, these are small scale suppliers who supply in small quantities. They break the bulk obtained from wholesalers so that it can be supplied in quantities suitable for small scale buyers. Say 1 kilogram, 2 kilogram, or they give them products. So it will take. So these are some of the types of suppliers. Factors consider when choosing the right supplier. What would you consider when choosing the right supplier? Having the right supplier is as important as any other aspect. Generally, the following factors should be put into consideration when selecting suppliers. 1. The price. This refers to the value of money. Suppliers providing supplies at low prices should be considered because it enables you to produce at a low cost and sell more. However, lowest prices may not always be the right choice, as it may be an indicator of poor quality. It is appropriate when all suppliers have the same quality, lead time, and higher factors. Quality. Suppliers with good quality products should be considered because if the quality of suppliers is low, then the quality you give to customers will also be low. And this has serious consequences of your sales and profits of your business. Lead time. This is the time between placing an order and the delivery of products. The shorter the lead time, the better the supplier. Financial capacity and security. It is always important to make sure your supplier has a strong financial position and cash flow to be able to deliver what you need in the required quantities and in time. A supplier that has good financial position is more appropriate than a supplier that has poor financial position. Strong service and clear communication. You need a supplier with clear system of communication and customer service. Someone will communicate to you everything that is. The distance between the business and the supplier also matters a lot. When the supplier is near, it is also easy to verify quality and follow up your orders. The nearer the supplier, the better. Credit and terms of payment. The terms of payment should also be seriously considered when choosing suppliers. Suppliers that demand 100% payment on order may not be favored, but suppliers that give credit should be favored because they are sure to supply the agreed quality. Lastly, but not least, means of transportation. Suppliers with their own means of transport in terms of delivery trucks are more reliable as compared to those without any public means. Quality control. The same, find out the quality control measures that the supplier has in place. Suppliers without good quality control measures will not supply quality products. Think of seeing this in some products where you buy a product and you find it is a suit. You find in some sockets there is nothing, and in other sockets there are 2 feet or a half of it. So it means they do not carry out an effective quality control. And past history, find out whom the supplier has dealt with before and the quality of service they have provided. This may be used as a source of information about their capacity. read the status of your supplier. Are these suppliers allowed? So it's also a factor to consider. If the supplier is not duly registered, does not belong to any trade association, and does not have the proper tax identification papers, such suppliers may not be worth dealing with. Having talked about that, I should say thank you for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed. We have looked at the market, started with defining what is the market, marketing needs, elements of the market. Then we looked at one by one, consumer survey, competitor survey. Today in this video I talked about product survey and supplier survey. Having gone through all that, then the next item will be the online quiz. Take time to do it and see where you fall.